The monsoons are yet to arrive Odisha. Summers are beating the jungles and temperature soaring above 40 degrees. The landscape is yet to be rejuvenated. The mesmerizing destinations and the diversity of the forest are yet to be seen and captured. So this time I decided to follow the path less traveled and the jungles which are less explored and bring to you the breathtaking flora and fauna of the forest. Welcome to Untamed and Unexplored Kuldiha Wildlife Sanctuary. Our stay at Kuldiha was arranged by Manoranjan Das, a well-known naturalist and bird guide who runs his hotel in Panchalingeshwar. A special thanks to him from the core of my heart for the lovely arrangements and his enormous efforts in the field that made the trip unforgettable one. The hotel is itself situated in the lap of the nature, surrounded by hills, and the Panchalingeshwar temple is just a few meter walk from the hotel.
We'll be going to Kuldiha Wildlife Sanctuary for wildlife photography. Our key species will be Malabar trogon, vernal hanging parrot, hard-spotted woodpecker, blue-eared kingfisher, and so on. Hopefully, I'll be able to get a glimpse of them. Look at the weather. It's a lovely morning. Hopefully it stays all through.
The next morning, we set pretty early, around 5:30 a.m. for Kuldiha Wildlife Sanctuary. The morning was misty and the sun was just about to clear the horizon. The Kuldiha Wildlife Sanctuary is situated in the Balasore district of Odisha. The sanctuary is spread across 272 square kilometers in the Chotanagpur Plateau. The sanctuary is characterized by a diverse ecosystem, primarily consisting of a mixed deciduous forest, where the majestic sal trees stand as the dominant species. The rich habitat harbors a plethora of wildlife, showcasing the incredible biodiversity of the forest. Among the notable inhabitants are the majestic tiger, elusive leopard, formidable elephants, sturdy gorse, graceful sambars, and vibrant peafowls. Acrobatic giant squirrel and flying squirrel can be also seen in the forest. housing a variety of birds of more than 282 species. The gorgeous Malabar trogon and vernal hanging parrot are worth mentioning. This sanctuary has achieved its own glory well beside Simlipal. Nevertheless, as it is connected with Simlipal via Nato and Sukhupara hill ranges, some mysterious features of the forest also reflects in here. As a result, the last Royal Bengal tiger sighted was evident from the place in the year 2009. As we entered the forest, all of a sudden an Indian pitta came to pay a visit. One of the most admired bird of India and famous for its rhythmic call from the treetop. The bird is often referred as Navrang, depicting nine colors on its feather. It is usually seen foraging on forest floors with thick undergrowth, catching insects in leaf litter. This bird is vocal, giving it characteristic two-noted whistle call at dawn and dusk. The bird began to start its daily duty by collecting some nesting materials. I was fortunate enough to capture the bird holding some nesting materials in its beak in the golden hour. Red earthen trails running through the dense and dark woods make the whole journey inside Kuldiha irresistible for nature lovers and jungle crazy people. Moreover, strategically placed watchtowers in different parts inside the forest have aided in the enthusiasm of wildlife lovers and bird watchers. The serene and vast beauty of Rishia Dam, along with the glimpse of Simlipal Range, takes people away to a different dimension during sunset. To test our luck, we decided to step out of our car and enter deep in the forest for birding. As we entered the forest, we were greeted by a group of brown-cheeked fulvetta that I managed to capture few shots. We moved on with our birding and very soon we saw a peninsular rock agama, a vibrant colored lizard displaying its beauty over a rock. We captured few shots and moved on. After spending few hours in that particular place, we managed to capture few more species like ruby-cheeked sunbird, pale-cheeked blue flycatcher, Indian pitta, and so on. We kept moving deep inside the forest in search of birds. Indian cuckoo and Indian pitta were constantly giving rhythmic calls from the treetop, probably to attract opposite partners. The rhythmic calls echoed throughout the forest and made their presence known. Then, all of a sudden, our guide took us to a spot where a female monarch was incubating her eggs in the nest. We approached the spot very calmly without disturbing the mother and maintaining a safe distance. I was able to capture some precious moments of the universal motherhood spirit of patience and perseverance that surely results in new generation in making. We were slowly losing our patience as we have got no sighting of the elusive Malabar trogon yet. We decided to take a break from birding and move to Kuldiha Forest Rest House, where we could take some rest and recharge our energies as it was very hot and humid. We had our lunch in the forest rest house and spent the whole afternoon in the watchtower. I want to thank the forest guards for preparing such a delicious food for us. Even from the watchtower, we could see a quite of bird activity was going on in and around the trees. I decided to take out my camera and start filming. From the watchtower, we got few commoners like white drum shama, coppersmith barbet, Asian brown flycatcher, common iora, oriental magpie robin, and black-naped monarch, to name a few. After completing our lunch, I decided to casually roam around the forest rest house with my guide. My other cobarders are still resting in the watchtower. Fortunately, this time I was carrying my camera. We started to minutely scan the top branches of the tall standing trees because we had prior knowledge that species like orange-breasted green pigeon, thick-billed green pigeon, hut-spotted woodpecker, and vernal hanging parrot can be spotted in those trees in and around the forest rest house. Suddenly, my guide called me out as he had spotted few movement behind the leaves in one of the trees. It was a group of 7 to 8 individuals of tail-capped pigeon. Yes, the rare and elusive pale-capped pigeon. We were delighted to get a glimpse of this bird. I would consider myself very fortunate even to see this bird through naked eye in the wild, and to get a shot of this bird, I couldn't ask for anything more. The pale-capped pigeon, also known as the purple wood pigeon, are patchily distributed in parts of Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia. They usually forages quietly in the crowns of fruiting trees. The vulnerable pale-capped pigeons are categorized under threatened species by the IUCN. After spending few more hours near the forest rest house, we added few more species in our wish list.
including spotted deer, Malabar giant squirrel, crested serpent eagle, Indian chameleon, and crimson sunbird.
We spent a lovely afternoon near the forest rest house. Now it's time to return back, as we were still missing our prime targeted species. We stopped near a local water source in search of blue-eared kingfisher, but the bird refuses to show up. The evening was setting quick and fast, so we decided to pay a visit to the Trogon area, with the only hope of getting the majestic species of the forest, the elusive Malabar Trogon. Suddenly, our guide spotted a small little bird under the thick canopy of the trees. Yes, it was the female Malabar Trogon. The queen of the forest seemed to be sitting under a thick foliage of leaves and branches, probably resting herself after the tiring day. It was quite challenging for us to get a clear shot of this elusive and rare Malabar Trogon, but any footage of this beauty is priceless. After a little search in the same area, we also got the male Malabar Trogon in nearby trees. Both the sexes display distinct and bright colors. The males has a black head and a bright red belly, whereas the females has a brown head and orangish underparts. And finally, after a long wait, I saw Malabar Trogon, the bird I dreamed of. Happiness was boundless as I got my wish list ticked. The sun began to quickly hide behind the trees, and just like that, my time in the forest had come to an end. My experience of exploring the remote jungles of Odisha was without a doubt life-changing. I returned with some rare documentation of a variety of birds, animals, and reptiles. After returning back from Kuldiha Wildlife Sanctuary to our hotel in Panchalingeshwar, we decided to go for an evening birding. The nocturnal species like owls and nightjars become active with the onset of darkness. The premises of the hotel where we were staying are having a vast stretch of open land and a quite a few tree cover, where we spotted an Indian scope owl eagerly waiting to catch its prey. As we moved a little further, we saw a spotted owlet in one of the branch of a tree. By then, the winds have picked up its pace. The spotted owlet is struggling to maintain the balance. It firmly holds on to the branches. I hope I could enrich your experience through this journey. If you enjoyed this documentary, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Many thanks to the entire team for believing in my vision of an independent wildlife documentary and helping me bring you diverse stories of animal kingdom from different parts of India. Your support will help me continue to tell stories of the wild and connect more people with the natural world. I will see you in another brand new series.